This is Divorce, Happy, and Successful, the number one spiritually focused self-empowerment podcast for divorced parents that's dedicated to helping you live the fulfilling life you deserve and experience the happiness you long for. Let's get into today's show with our host, W. Mark Watts.
Hey, everybody, it's W. Mark Watts, and I want to thank you so very much for hanging out with me again this week. And today's episode is just about finding hope after divorce. So I was reading an article of the same name today, and it was about a lady whose marriage has come to an end, and she was moving out and packing up her things and starting over again. And of course, she was at that very dark place. Now, for those of us who've been through it, which are probably the majority of people who listen to the podcast, we all know what that place feels like, what it looks like, what it smells like. And for some, it's worse than others. But still, I think across the board, we all have experienced that loneliness or that ending, or if you will, the death of something. We've all felt that, and we've all been afraid and unsure. At least I know I am. I'll speak for myself. You're afraid, you're unsure. When there's kids involved, you're wondering how it's going to affect the kids. So the article was just really about, you know, how after a year or two, she looked back and realized that she was so much happier now than she had been, you know, at that time she was divorced and making that decision to move on in a different direction. And so I just wanted to piggyback on that a little bit, because that's really what this podcast is all about. It's all about, you know, just how to pick up the pieces and move on with your life. And really, at the end of the day, it's really about just how to live the life that you want to live, regardless of what you've been through. And so I just want to touch on a few thoughts that I jotted down after I read the article, because I look back, I've been real introspective and look back at my life and the life of my sisters and friends and family members and my son. And I feel like there's some things that I just wanted to touch on. So I'm not going to keep you long today, but let's go ahead and hop right into it. You know, a lot of times the fact that people are divorced or come from divorced families, oftentimes in the media gets such negative publicity that I like to shed a little different light and take a different angle, because it's not 100% bad. And I don't want anyone to feel that way consistently. Yes, are there times when it can be tough? Are there struggles? Absolutely. Not going to turn a blind eye to that. But as far as people and getting through things like this, we are really resilient. You know, individuals are resilient. Oftentimes, you know, what you'll find is the people who we think are the weakest are actually the strongest. And we all have within us the ability to be strong and to be weak. But what I really like and what I've really learned throughout the process is that how people over time and as situations change, we come through it. And so don't ever be concerned with the fact that you won't get through it, because you will get through it. People get through it all the time, and they have for a long, long, long time. So it might be tough and it might be dark in that moment, but just hold tight and understand that it will get better. It doesn't last always. Situations and things change, and they oftentimes do, even when you're not even really thinking about it. You know, there's no real hard and fast rules. It just bugs me when you hear the statistics about kids that come from divorced homes and the things that happen. You know, they fail at a higher rate. They drink more. They're more likely to become addicts, et cetera, on and on and on. But what you really look into those statistics, and when I look out in my life, which is a lot of what I judge, you know, those statistics with and the things that I know about it myself, I look and I see those types of issues are prevalent regardless of whether you come from a divorced home or you come from a home where both parents were there. Now, might there be a slight edge in those statistics based on the fact that parents are divorced. What I really find more so than the piece about them being divorced is whether or not both parents are involved in the kids' lives is the key. And you can have that dysfunction in a house where there's a married couple or the couple has been divorced. So that is the key. It ultimately ends up in how you parent, period, and a relationship that you have with your kids, period, regardless of if you're divorced or married. So there's just don't get caught up in letting people play, just paint you with the broad stroke and just say, hey, if you're divorced, this is going to happen. Or if you're divorced, you can't do this. I don't buy any of that foolishness. I believe that I ultimately in charge of what happens to me and the people I affect. And I believe that I really can affect those things positively. And I work toward that every day. And you can still dream just because you're divorced. So what? That's merely one chapter of your life. You've got to get through that chapter. You've got to still reach back and think about those things that you dreamed about, that you wondered about. You know, if this relationship didn't work out for you and you thought that this was going to be the end all be all, you know what? Maybe it wasn't. Maybe that wasn't the one that you had dreamed about. You know, we all do things that when we look back and we say, well, maybe I should have done something different. Well, now is your time to do something different. Don't get caught up in putting all your eggs in that basket and saying, oh, that was such a horrible experience. I'm never going to do it again. Or I'll never be able to find, you know, that person, or I'll never have that situation. If you continue to say that, then you won't. You'll continue to push it away. So yeah, that one didn't work, but there's steps and things that you can really do to regroup and really put yourself in a position to still go for what you dreamed of and what you long for and what you really deserve to have. You can still do it. And I'm sure that you will. Now, one thing that I've really learned over the course of my life here is that every event, and I boil it down to really this simple, simple concept. And that is every event in your life is just an opportunity to learn, to grow and elevate your game, no matter what it is. Yes, there are some tremendous tragedies, some things that really happen that are horrific in this world. And I get that. And we all will experience some degree of those things. But at the end of the day, it's still an event. It's still something that happened in your life. You've got to learn from it. You've got to grow from it. And you've got to keep going and you've got to elevate your game, because if you don't, then what is the flip side? If you just settle, if you give up, if you never can get beyond the pain, if you're unable to forgive, then you are going to be stuck in a place that I'm sure you don't want to be in. So the only way to move past these events is to look at find the lesson, take that opportunity to grow and improve, step your game up, because I can guarantee you, and I've seen this in my life where things have been really dark for me. If you listen to some of them past episodes, it was 2 months after I moved out and my former wife and I were 100% certain that we were getting divorced, never going back. I lost my job. So I had just moved into a really nice new condo and lost my job and couldn't pay for it. So what do you do when that happens? I definitely didn't think that was going to happen, but it happened to me. And yes, that was a tough stretch there. I'm still trying to support my son, dealing with my divorce emotions, trying to make sure everything's taken care of. And here we go. I don't even have a job. But I couldn't stop. I couldn't give up. It was too important. I mean, there were moments that I wanted to give up. I felt like giving up. There were many days I was tired and stressed out, but you know what? I kept going and I figured out that there were some lessons. There were some things I needed to do to get better. And as I continued to work on myself, things started getting better for me. And don't listen to other people's negativity. I mean, I remember, you know, hearing things as a kid. growing up, people would say about, you know, not or coming from a divorced parent or divorced household, and, you know, just automatically thinking, assuming that kids won't perform well in school, you know, that just gives us an excuse. I hold my son to the highest of standards, just as if he is, his mother and I was still married. It doesn't matter that his parents are divorced. There, the standard is the standard. He's got to work his butt off in school and do the things that he needs to do to become a better person so that he can function in life and live his dreams, just as if nothing else matters. So it, who cares where, you know, what his parents, that his parents are divorced? It doesn't matter to me. I don't see that. When I look at him, I see a young man that needs to grow and learn and have fun and enjoy this life, and that his parents are an intricate part of teaching him those things. That's what I see when I look at my son and when I look at any young person and when I look at adults. You have that same, the same things apply. We all have to continue to learn. We all have to work hard. We all deserve to have fun and enjoy this wonderful gift called life. It doesn't matter. And I don't get caught up, and I hope you don't ever get caught up in people's negativity. It's just talk. You know, look beyond that mess. You know who you are, and you know what you can become. And that's got to be the focus. Forget about that negative crap that's out there, because it'll bring you down and it'll only stop you on your way to greatness. And lastly, I just want to leave you with, you know, I always believe in better. You just got to, no matter what you're going through, you've got to believe in better. And it doesn't have to be a drastic better. You know, sometimes better, sometimes what you're looking for comes in baby steps, you know, just slightly better. You know, when I'm coaching and training people, I believe in the 3% rule, and that three, or the rule of three, I call it. And I just say, let's strive for 3% better, just 3%. Let's not go for the whole 100%. Let's not go for the whole overnight success model where you want to wake up one day and just everything's different. Let's just strive in this moment. What can we do to be 3% better than we were, than that situation, than that thought, than that last action? Can I forgive a person 3% more today than I did yesterday? Can I forgive myself 3% more today than I did? You know, just the 3% rule. Let's just move it just a tad bit. And what you will see is, if you commit to that in that moment, and then next week you do the same thing, and maybe the following week you don't get 3%. Maybe it stays the same. Maybe you regress a little bit. But if in that moment your focus is, let's get just a little bit better, over time you're going to see a huge improvement. You're going to see that you feel a lot better about yourself. There's things that will be uncovered in you, and there's things that you will find if you will just focus on just be a little bit better. Just believe in better. If you will do that, things will definitely change in your life, and you will definitely be on the road to paradise, which is where we all want to go if we're not there right now. All right, that's all I got for you tonight. I'm going to let you get back on to your day or your evening or your morning, depending on when you listen to this podcast. So if this podcast has been helpful to you in any way, shape, or form, please rate it, tell your friends about it, share it on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, everywhere you hang out. And also listen to some of the older episodes, because, you know, if you're like me at all, it takes me numerous times to listen to things and for it to sink in. You know, we're all busy, so it takes that repetition to let some of these things sink in and really start to, you know, use them and make them more effective in your life. All right. Well, that's it. I look forward to talking with you again next week. And until that time, take care of yourself. Keep striving, because paradise is out there for you. Talk with you soon. Bye now.
You've been listening to the Divorce, Happy, and Successful podcast. If you enjoyed today's show, be sure to leave us a 5-star rating and review on iTunes. Until next time, stay focused and keep moving forward.